Alright folks, now then, in this video we're going to look at two things. We're going to look at these guys' microphones, and also what we're going to look at, which is very important, is the art of mixing using sounds, not beats, sounds. Now then, the reason I'm saying this is because for a mobile DJ who has got a lot of 7-inch singles to mess around with, not the long 12-inches with long introductions and long endings, when you've got a 7-inch single, or when you've got the equivalent of just a chart single, which is about 3 minutes 30 seconds, that's about the average, you haven't really got much time to mess around with intros and outros. So, a way of mixing, okay, which maybe it doesn't go in beat, but like I've said in past videos, beat mixing is brilliant, because the crowd are dump, they're going with the beat. But what's just as important is actually mixing the sounds, the tone, the feel. So I'm going to do that in a minute with a bit of a mix for you, okay? Again, I said mix, but it's almost like a blend, all right, where we're blending two sounds together. Now then, someone has emailed me and they've said, when do you use a microphone? Do you need to use a microphone? Why use a microphone? In other words, there's all these sort of questions. Who uses a microphone? Let me just move that up a tad, like that. That's a bit better. Right, now then. There's lots of different kinds of microphones. This here is known as a wireless microphone. Why? Because it's wireless, okay? There's a lot more to it than that. This here, that is a microphone. That is a lapel microphone because it sits here, and that's for functions, you know, for speeches and people maybe who need to use their hands, both hands. If I put that there, I can use my hands now and you can hear me through that, let's say. Right, also, these are microphones, these guys here. That one there is a good one for vocals. That one there is a good one for instruments. The list goes on. They come in all shapes and sizes, and a lot of professional microphones are used for different things. In other words, you could have a fantastic microphone that could cost £100, £200, £300. It will be the best thing in the world for a drummer. But then, if you sang into that, it would make you sound terrible. This guy here.
1, 2, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. It's not unusual to be loved by anyone.
We'll come into that in a minute, right? Now, this is a wireless microphone. This is what I use in a lot of functions, because when you're walking around all the gear, you haven't got to worry about a cable, because believe me, cables can get in the way, they can pull, they can twist, they can break. It's a pain in the ass. You've got one of these guys and you just walk around everywhere. You can go around to the people, you can have a bit of fun with the punters. So, right, why do we need a microphone? Now then, club DJs, what you'll find very often, just checking the time, a club DJ will very, very rarely use a microphone because the guy's been paid a lot of money to come in and play the music. Quite often in a nightclub, you will never hear a person use the microphone. There's no need. The music says it all. The guy walks in, he plays his set, he finishes, he says bye-bye to the crowd. Quite often he'll just wave like that, and off he goes. Yes, occasionally you will get a DJ who'll want to use the microphone. I tell you what, the DJs, the big club DJs who do use a microphone, I take my hat off to them. Spot on, because you're almost being a part of the crowd, you're speaking to them. That's what they want. The crowd love it. When you talk to them and say, hello, how are you? Fine, brilliant, bomb. And then you play the music. It's one hell of, it's more of a buzz. It lifts you that little bit higher. Fantastic. But a mobile DJ, all right, if you're a mobile DJ and you don't use one of these, then I'm afraid you're not really a mobile DJ. Because you've got to communicate with a crowd. You have to speak to them. You've got to get involved. In other words, the thing is, what I find with a mobile DJ, when I'm using this microphone here, you're actually playing a part with the crowd. You're getting involved with them. You're being a... Hold on, let me check the time. Yeah, we're all right. You're almost... It's a communication. It's a form of talking, which is what it's all about. I know, yeah, you're talking in here like this, and you're talking to the crowd, but if you just sit behind the turntables, behind the CD players, and play music, and smile and wave, then the way I look at it is that crowd might as well have paid some money and got a jukebox, because that's all you're doing, because they're just putting money into a jukebox and listening to the music. A good DJ uses this, and this is what brings him to the people. This, in other words, it's almost, if you imagine the people are here, This is the microphone, this is the DJ. This guy joins everything together. Right, now then, very quickly, with regards blending music, yes, it's very good if a DJ can actually blend two tunes, the beat goes. But a lot of mobile DJs, including me, if you're using 7-inch singles, you listen, use your ear, you listen to the tone, and you blend the two together. Right, I'll show you. Right, what we've got here, we've got two tracks, which is Los Lobos, La Bamba, and then we've got Tom Jones, It's Not Unusual. Now then, the beats won't really go together. If you listen to Los Lobos, check it out. Right, here we go. I'm going to bring Tom Jones, It's Not Unusual, into the end of that. I'm not going to beat mix it, nothing. What I'm going to do, I'm going to have this record here ready. I'm going to have my finger ready. If you've got CD players, it's exactly the same as getting it right to the beginning and getting ready to press start. So we're not beat matching, we're just going bang from this one to that one. Now then, the beat may be on, as in boom, boom, la bamba, bam, bam, and then bam, in here, but I'm not beat mixing it. The beats aren't going together. It's literally bang, from one straight to the other. The main thing is, it sounds right, it works well. So, when the crowd are dancing, they're not all of a sudden gonna be doing dun, 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 and then stop, look around, what's going on, and then start again. If you do that, quite often you'll see half the crowd disappear, because it's almost like, what's the DJ done? He sort of changed the atmosphere, okay? So what I'll do, I'll go on the headphones, I'm going to do this mix, one to the other, and then what I'm going to do it another way by using the microphone, and just all of a sudden, imagine that I've got a crowd in front of me, and I'm going to be introducing the next song. So here we go, here's the first one, with no introduction, just me having this song and going straight into the other one. So we'll just wang it back a little bit, here we go. So there you go, that's exactly what I did. As soon as that one finished, bang, straight to the other one. Now I'm going to do the same thing, but I'm going to introduce the next song using the microphone. Let's see the difference. And yes, you've heard it 1,000 times. But then again, you know what they say, 1,001 is better than 1,000. It could be even extra, because it's what we like. This one is dedicated to every single lady out there who has just left their husband at home and has finally realised that they can enjoy themselves tonight. It's Tom Jones. So there you go, you see? That is quite often what a DJ will do, use the microphone. Hope that's been a help. Practice and enjoy. There's a lot more to this than meets the eye. You take it easy.